Hi, everyone. So today, Andrew and Nick, we're here with another review for you. This is Pneuma, track number 2 on the Fear Inoculum album. Instant favorite in my eyes, which gave way to some of their other songs later on the album. But this one, Tool messaging to a T. I'm not going to give too much away. Obviously, you know multiple languages, so you're probably developing your own idea of what Pneuma could be before we even get there. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, I mean, just right off the bat, just like pneumonia, Pneuma is about respiration. It's about breath, right? In the ancient Stoic philosophy, Pneuma was also equated with the vital soul, right? And if that brings us back into biblical imagery of Hashem breathing life into the clay form of man, right? This vital soul being transmitted through breath. Also, in Hebrew, there are actually 5 different words for soul, or even he might even call them 5 different levels of soul. And one of them is ruach, wind. It's actually the where we get the idea of the Holy Spirit, Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Wind, or the Holy Spirit, right? The words, it means the same thing, spirit or wind, both. And it's this idea of the movement of air and that being an essence of some sort of vital being, you know? Breathing, as we've learned over the last couple months,
it can be very helpful.
Yeah. You want to keep doing that as long as possible.
For sure. Well, I mean, that's a pretty apt descriptor on your end. Let's get right into it. These songs are pretty long, and we want to have room at the back to discuss further. So without further ado, this is Pneuma.
Here we go. Pneuma.
Yeah, you're gonna love all of these. They've got big, long, arcing instrumental intros.
Yeah. So cool. Like I said before, so painfully obvious why this is an instant favorite. I mean, wow. Great music.
Yeah. Great message. Oh, man.
And really, like I said at the beginning, there's kind of this musical, in the chords, is this musical callback to the beginning, like with Sober, right?
And I think there's this. Well, the timing is definitely different, but I think
absolutely
the chords are right in there. I think what you're hearing is that they dropped. They dropped into another octave. Somebody out in the comments will definitely clue me in as to specifically what's going on. But Maynard's not going to be screaming nearly as much as he used to. The guys are definitely older, if you couldn't tell by just the progression and the building of the songs there. But so they've dropped into, I want to say, maybe a more somber octave, a more, definitely, I would use the phrase awake, not just to be cliche with this song, but it seems like it's no longer a scream into the void. It's more of like standing on the precipice of the void and looking at everything all at once.
The desperation is gone, right? There's a command of the situation. This is it. We are now aware. We've overcome the filth and the mire that is the reality of our physical situation, and we have gained this extra perception that sees the system from above, and even from this perspective, what seemed like filth and mire before is all part of the perfection.
The system. Yeah, it's all there.
It's all necessary, right? Yeah.
So when I look up what people are talking about this song, and of course, definitely to me, like you said, breath, he says it pretty clearly in there that we are all one breath. A lot of people lean on the affect of collective consciousness that, probably one of my favorite points in all of this song that he refers to is that we're all one spark, the sun becoming. Basically, we're all made of the same stardust. We all become that same thing, and we've only got so much time on the planet. And so once we acknowledge that and realize that we're all collectively together, you can almost take that big, deep societal breath. You know, that whether everything's going to be okay or in the end, everything's not going to matter. So do with this time that you will, you know. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Oh, we're getting the ladder again. Okay.
Yeah, we're getting the drawings again. So, okay. Let's, just because there was a lot going on lyrically here, like you're talking, we have the theme of light, we have remembering, we have this waking up, right? So, okay, just some quick reminders here. We have the world of Asiya, which means action. We've got the world of Yetzira, which means I don't know, like formation. And then we've got the world of Bria, which is like creation. And you know, then that's enough for now. Down here we also have we talked about this idea of the Malchut, right? This is the the very bottom. This is where
the bottom,
we are.
The grime. Yeah.
Well,
reality, right?
Right, but
as we perceive it.
Our physical reality, as we perceive it, is actually down here. We're
below
outside
it.
We're outside of the system. We're not in it yet, because we're still 100% in the ego. Anything up here, anything up above, and we have some sort of sensation of the creator. Okay. Got some sort of sensation of the creator, and we're no longer solely egotistical. We have this feeling of bestowal. Okay, so Malchut is the lowest form of that, right? And it is equated with the soul of the Neshema, right? Whereas one step above that. This is Zir Anpin or Tiferet. Tiferet is like the glory, the splendor, and this is connected to the level of soul of Ruach, which we talked about before. So we're beyond just the basic level of bestowal here. We're feeling this conduit and this tiferet, right? Before that, let's go up one more. We'll go up to here. We'll have Bria is like chokhmah, ma, and it is connected to the nefesh, another word for soul. I mean, like. In the Aleut language, there's like 27 different words for snow, because they live in it all the time. Hebrew is a language that's specifically designed to talk about spirituality, and that's why there's 5 different words for soul, because there's 5 different ways of perceiving and experiencing the soul, right?
So when he's describing bound to this flesh, we go around with one foot nailed down, and then he describes basically, well, I mean, are you seeing like an ascension path? Like he's singing out like this roadmap to you. You're hearing these terms.
Yeah, I'm hearing these terms, and okay, there is a little bit of Christian imagery in there, especially with the word, the logos, right? That's, I think, the first thing, I think maybe it's the Gospel of John. In the beginning, there was the Word, right? We're talking, that's the Logos. This is something a little
one
bit
word.
Outside, right? It's a little bit outside of Jewish thought, but it's also connected, because in the Zohar, which is the principal text of Kabbalah, there is a whole discussion of how each letter of the Hebrew alphabet came before the Creator and, you know, made its argument for why the universe should be made with it. And there was a specific word that was used, and that was Bereshit, right? In the beginning. It's the first word in the Torah. Anyway, so there is this kind of connection back to the older tradition, but this whole logos idea is very, very Christian. But with the rest of it, though, the awakening, the whole idea of the awakening and remembering, there is this term reshema or reshemot. Reshemot is plural. Remembrances, right? That down here below, we have some sort of memory, some sort of nascent memory of the soul. Right.
So it's, that's the wake up, remember, we are all one breath. Okay. So that's it's a call to action. This is what you're hearing. You're hearing the call out, which is great because I hear that too without these tethers directly. You know, with the study of Buddhism and then just basically looking at everything from an outside perspective and not wanting to pin down a specific religious purpose, I see a lot of, hey, we're all made of stardust and this is all energy and it's all just forms of energy that are outside of our perspective, outside of our ability to really understand what they are. So when I hear a song like this, I can definitely get those calling deep undertones of wake the fuck up. Remember that you're not just a sack of meat, you know, your video games aren't important, your car's not necessarily important, but the connections with all the people that are just like you are important.
And if you think about this idea of wind as a spirit, right? Wind is produced by convection, where part of the atmosphere is heated and part of the atmosphere is cooled, right? So hot air going up, cold air falling, and now you've got this differential which causes wind. Now, you can't say that one part of the atmosphere is wind and the other part isn't. It's all interconnected. That movement of air is global. It's one. There can't be there can't be a differentiation. There can't be an isolation, right? There can be intensities, local intensities, but it's all interconnected, right? So this idea of wind, of ruach, of breath as a life force is definitely something that connects us all to one. Yeah, for sure.
It's beautiful. Very cool. Song. One thing I wanted to bring up also, I mean, the guys had 13 years to figure out exactly where they wanted to go from an instrument standpoint. And as with tradition, we've been doing a couple live shows. There is a live inside over Danny Carey's shoulder drum cam of this. So we'll be able to react to a live performance of this song. We'll save that for the towards the end of the album. And you'll be able to see that every single one of those percussion sounds, whether they were a full hit of a drum or something electronic, dude's got an electric xylophone that he travels with this year on tour or before. So, or at least that's what it looks like to me. I'm sure, I think it's called the tomblas. Somebody's gonna slaughter me over having the instrument pronounced wrong, but it's a full 360 cage and it's set up according to sacred geometry. And it's almost like he figured out that if he puts things in the specific order, he can hit every single one of them seemingly at the same time. So,
Amazing.
It should be quite a bit of fun for us.
I mean, there is so much musically going on. Yes, I mean, they have really developed as a group. There's so much musically going on. I just want to make a quick shout out to one of our commenters, Michael Peterson, who let us know that the what we thought was a bowed instrument at the beginning of Fear Inoculum was actually this trading of volume swells between the guitar and the bass between Adam and Justin, which is a great thing to share. Thank you so much.
Yeah, that's crazy. Because it does, really it sounds imagined. Like a rising and a falling and a swelling that would come from pulling on a bow.
Oh, cool. And just to have, the imagination to do that. I mean, that's art, to trailblaze, to do new things with instruments that people didn't think to do. That's so cool.
Yeah, it's absolutely awesome. So, yeah, I mean, thank you guys so much for joining us all the way here to the end. If you made it this far, make sure that you like. You probably already subscribed, but yeah, if you haven't, go ahead and do so. We love hearing your feedback. Tell us what Pneuma is all about to you. Tell us what you're looking forward to. And, of course, hit us up with recommendations. We're going to be looking at A Perfect Circle, Pussifer, and any other bands that we can get a hold of with similar messaging. So thanks again for joining us. Until next time.
Peace and love. See you next time.
Peace.